Well, hello, hello. I'm Minister William Edward Turner, your pre-engagement coach. And today we're going to be talking about element number two, equation for happiness. But before we get started with that, I want to be sure that you like and share, because there's someone who needs this wisdom from this session. So, element number two is equation for happiness. God's word says in Psalm 37, 4 and 5 in the King James Version, delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Commit your ways to the Lord and trust in him, and he shall bring it to pass. Psalm 37, 3 through 6 in the Message Bible says this: get insurance with God and do a good deed. Settle down and stick to your last. Keep company with God. Get in on the best. Open up before God and keep nothing back. He'll do whatever you need to be done. He'll validate your life in the clear daylight and stamp you with the approval at high noon. You know, there's sometimes major hindrances to our happiness. And one of the bigger major hindrances is our ego. Ego means easing God out. We ease God out of our life, out of our marriage, out of our relationships, out of business. We do it pretty much out of everything. One of the things is that sometimes we even change God's way of doing things for the ways of the world. That spiritual attitude, an attitude of, I know what I'm doing. I don't need your help. You can't tell me anything about relationships, marriage, operating a household, or anything else. I got this. But God tells us in his word that we should obtain good counsel before we plan anything. And marriage is something that we definitely need good counsel in. In Proverbs 15:22, it says, refuse good advice and watch your plans fail. Take good counsel and watch them succeed. And that's the King James Version. Oh, that was the Message Version. But in the Amplified Version, it says, where there is no counsel, purposes are frustrated, but with many counselors, they are accomplished. And in the King James Bible, it says, without counsel, purposes are disappointed, but in the multitude of counselors, they are established. It is in our faith that God's word is true and our obedience to his word, we have success. Therefore, this is the equation for happiness. Faith plus obedience equals success. Now, this does not mean that you won't have any issues, that there won't be hard times, that you'll not have to make some sacrifice, but it does mean that you will come through those valley times because God is in the valley with you. As it says in Psalms 23:4, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. God said in his words in Proverbs 3:5-8, in the King James Version, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. The activities that we have here in element number two, equation for happiness, it assists couples in establishing habits and practices to maintain their unity and trust for each other. And with that trust comes a lot of your relationship cohesiveness, how it's going to stay together. As we know that I can trust you, that you've got my back, I've got your back. And even if something doesn't come out right out of my mouth, I don't say it right. But because we've developed that trust relationship before going in to marriage, we know that you weren't really trying to hurt me. It might have not been phrased the best it could, but that was not your intentions to hurt me. So we developed that trust and unity in the equation of happiness. Therefore, we can have that faith, obedience, and that success that helps us move forward in a marriage that's going to last forever. Wow, that was a great session. Remember to like and share, because there's someone who needs the wisdom from today's session. I'm Minister William Edward Turner, your pre-engagement coach. And until next time, blessings eternally.